Yes, I continue the discussion from yesterday. So yesterday I gave definition of Kobachma buffer invariant when the modular space of one-dimensional stable shifts is non-singular. That was previously proposed by Hosono Saito Takahashi. And yesterday I could not give some example for that conjecture. But let me recall the conjecture. So let X be smooth projective C by 3 over complex number field, and let M be, M is a modular space of one-dimensional stable shapes with this chain character, and we consider the Hilbert chain map from here to here. So, so this is just for getting the information of the sieve on the curve. That is, for example, if you take a smooth curve here, then the fiber is nothing but usual Jacobian. But of course, if this curve is non-singular, then this fiber is much more complicated. And anyway, so under the assumption that M is smooth, then the intersection complex of this variety is just the constant shift, up to shift. And in this case, we can define the Kobachma buffer invariant just like taking the push forward of Faber's push forward of the constant shift shift by dimension of M. By I. So this is, so this function, this polynomial of Y is uniquely written as in this way. And that can be used to define Kobachma buffer invariant in this case. And the conjecture which I stated last time was NGBP. So this is the Kobachma buffer type invariant which is defined from stable pairs. So if you consider modular space of stable pairs, then this is this one. No, there's no P. P. So yes, this is defined from a stable pair. No. This is defined from a stable pair. So equals to NG beta. So this appears, yeah. So this one is defined by thinking about modular space of stable pairs, that is something like pairs of curves and points on them, and this is defined from modular space of one-dimensional stable shapes, that is modular space of curves and vector bundles on it. So let me give one example. So in the last time, I gave a computation of the left-hand side for some elliptically fibered Calabi-Yau three-fold that is given by so-called wire stress model, so which I explained yesterday, so I don't repeat here. So this is the wire stress model. So this is elliptic fibration. So that every fiber is either smooth elliptic curve or nodal rational curve or cuspidal rational curve. So in this case, yesterday we observed that N0, okay, so F is a fiber class, N0 MF is minus Euler number of X, and so P N1 M F P equal to ES and higher genus vanish. So anyway, so this follows from the computation of the wall crossing formula. And yes, and it involves computation of the multiple cover conjecture of generalized Donaldson-Thomas invariant. On the other hand, in this case, this right-hand side is much easier to compute. So let me give some its computation. So in this case, if you consider like beta equal, well, if beta is multiple of fiber class, in this case, the child variety is nothing but, well, this is the moduli space of cycles with homology class multiplied by its fibers. So the moduli space of one cycle with homology class, MF is nothing but the choosing some M number of fibers of that FT5 version. So the child variety is nothing but the symmetric product of S. On the other hand, if you consider moduli space of stable sheaves, so because every stable sheaf should have a compact, have connected support, every stable sheaf should be supported on one of the fibers. And indeed, and also if you consider moduli space of stable bundles on, for example, one of fibers, then it is well known that the moduli space of stable bundles is isomorphic to the original underlying elliptic curve. And in this case, yeah, it is easy to see that this is indeed isomorphic to the original X. And under this isomorphism, this Hilbert chair map can be just identified with this diagonal map. So in order to compute this number, it is enough just to compute the push forward of constant sheaf to here. So if we compute, yes. And also in this case, it is easy to see that in this case, pi star of intersection complex, so this is of course constant sheaf shifted by three. This is given by S shifted by one plus V plus S by minus one, and V is a certain perverse sheaf on S. Yeah, indeed, so V is nothing but the constructive sheaf such that shifted by two. And yeah, so this is a certain constructive sheaf on downstairs, and it is not local constant. But if you consider the fiber of this constructive sheaf, then of course this is nothing but H1 XSQ. So this is just Q2 if XS is smooth. So in this case, this is the smooth elliptic curve. And if XS is nodal rational curve, and this is zero if X has only cuspidal rational curve. So the picture is like this. So if we draw the picture of this base, I have this base space, and there is a discriminant locus that is a divisor on base, on which the fiber is singular. And of course, in the generic point of this base, the fiber is a smooth elliptic curve. And at the generic point of this discriminant locus, where the fiber is a nodal rational curve with one node. And at some special point, I get some capital rational curve. But in any case, you can just write this as the Q plus to minus Euler number of the fiber. So this information is enough to compute about Kobach-Mobaff invariant in this case. And indeed, in this case, we can just compute from the definition that we should compute intersection complex CS plus Y plus V plus, sorry, minus 1 ICS Y, but of course, this is a constant shift up to shift, so its Euler characteristic is nothing but the Euler number of the base. And the Euler number of V can be computed using this computation. So this means just like S, Y inverse plus. This becomes just ES Y inverse plus 2 ES minus the number of EX plus SY, and that is just written as minus Euler number of X plus Euler number of SY square plus Y square. So by this expression, of course, this is N0 MF, and this is N1 MF, and so there are no terms, so there is no higher genus term. So in this case, we have the agreement of the computation which appeared from the wall crossing formulas in stable pair side. So, and of course, in this case, the conjecture comparing Kobach-Mobaff invariants defined from stable pairs and Kobach-Mobaff invariants defined from fiber sheaves indeed coincide. But yes, the problem is, after since when Hosono Saito Takahashi paper appeared, there has been a problem how to construct Kobach-Mobaff invariants when the moduli space of stable sheaves, one-dimensional stable sheaves, is indeed singular. So the question is that. Is how to define the beta when M is singular. And there are some history about this problem. And of course, the first approach was given by Hosono Saito Takahashi in their 2001 paper. And their argument was to use the intersection cohomology of the normalization of of this possibly singular scheme M. So let me recall about approach by Hosono Saito Takahashi. So so first let's take a normalization. So this is normalization. And let's take U to be dense open subset. So yes, of course, intersection complex can be defined for singular variety. And in this case, this is more complicated, even by image of the category of power sheaves. Anyway, so this is intersection complex that just lives in the power sheaves on M tilde. And yeah, the classical result by Bemison, Bemstein domain implies the decomposition theorem for the hypercohomology of this intersection complex. So this is the image in power sheaves. So the approach is just replace the intersection complex which appeared for when M is not singular to this intersection complex. So what do they construct? Yeah, I'm assuming, yeah, this is the, yes, sorry, yes, of course, yes. Oh, sorry, yes, thank you. So what they did is replace HM for when M is smooth case by this intersection complex. Just like so. Still, we get some number, which I write also on Saito Takahashi invariant. But, yes, but unfortunately, so this invariant does not match with the invariants coming from stable pairs or like Gromov-Witt invariants. Well, this is because in this definition, so, well, we only think about the topological property of this moduli space and do not take care about the scheme structure. And for example, we observed that when G equals zero, G plus zero, then the by the wall crossing formula N zero beta P must be equal to the integration of the Bevent function over the moduli space of stable sheaves. And if when M is non-singular, this is nothing but well, topological Euler number of M up to sign. But when M is non-singular, when M is singular, then this Bevent function fits the feature of the singularities, and it may be far from the Euler number of this moduli space. For example, it may happen that well, M might be just topological one point, but scheme theoretically, there might be some fat point. And in that case, the Bevent function is not one, and it reflects the length of the scheme, length of the structure sheaf of M. But in that case, the Hosono Saito Takahashi construction only gives just one. So in general, this is not equal to N0 beta HST. So anyway, the problem is whether how to involve like variant function or Seehofer vanishing cycles in this construction. Yes, but yeah, indeed, by the definition of Kopka buffer invariant, so this is for when M is a smooth case. So as I explained yesterday, for example, when chi bar is just 1 point, then the polynomial which computes Kopka buffer invariant is nothing but the usual Poincaré polynomial. And the usual Donaldson-Thomas invariant is something like something like Euler number of the moduli space of stable sheaves. And and this means that we have to give some sort of refinement of the Donaldson-Thomas type invariant so that it also involves like Poincaré polynomial or so on. So that is has to do with the problem of how to construct so-called motivic Donaldson-Thomas invariants or cohomological Donaldson-Thomas invariants in a somewhat rigorous way. But anyway, so in Wednesday, we saw that, well, if you consider moduli stack of coefficient sieves, then it is locally written as critical locus of some function. So let's recall that in this. So this is divine choice. And it's collaborators that this moduli space of, so this property holds for any moduli space of objects in derived category, but this M is covered by some open covering. And each open set is embedded into smooth scheme. So this is smooth. And this is regular function such that UI, each UI is given by critical locus. And in Wednesday, if we are given such data, it is possible to construct certain complex of constructive sheaves. That is called the Seehofer of vanishing cycles. And indeed, the Seehofer vanishing cycles is an object of the Barber's sheaves on UI, so I get Barber's sheaf on each UI. So one of the problems about this is that, well, yeah, whether we can use these Barber's sheaves to give a global Barber's sheaf. So the question is that, well, how to glue. Yes, this kind of problem has been one of the foundational problem in constructing like a cohomological Donaldson-Thomas invariant, or you can also replace the Seehofer vanishing cycles by so-called motivic Milner fiber motivic vanishing cycles, and you can ask whether such such element in the Grothendieck group of varieties glue together to get some kind of motif. And yes, in recent years, there have been several works to give rigorous treatment about the gluing of these Barber's sheaves. And so here, I refer the work by Dominic Joyce using the notion of so-called D-critical structure. So this is after Joyce. Yes, indeed, he showed that, well, yeah. So for this statement, yeah, we have one strong statement. That is, we can, yes, in order to glue these Barber's sheaves, we need to know somehow revisions of this local chart in some way. Well, For example, the nice thing is that, well, if, for example, if you just add some quadratic form of this function, then you get the same critical locus. And in that case, well, the sheaf vanishing cycles are very close to the sheaf vanishing cycles before adding quadratic term. So his critical structure implies that we can take such local critical chart in some part that, yeah, indeed they are on the overlap, they are different, but they at most differ by something like quadratic forms, like that. So, yeah, so I explain what is this structure. So, indeed, he showed that there is a canonical. Sheaf of C vector spaces. Satisfying some properties. Indeed, this sheaf can be explicitly described using like cotangent complex or so on, but the important property is that, well, for any open subset and for any embedding into smooth, closed embedding into smooth scheme, such that where I is the idea which defines this closed subscheme, we get the exact sequence, that is, if you restrict this SM to you get like OV I square to like omega V like this. So, well, this description implies that, well, for example, if you take open subset and closed embedding, and if this closed subscheme is indeed defined by critical locus of some function, that is, if f is a linear function such that where u is just critical locus and I is, so in this case, of course, I is given by the idea generated by the differential of this function f. And in this case, we have a natural section of this sheaf vector space on U that is just, if we just take it's an image of F in here, gives a global section of SM. Yeah, this one. Yes, so yeah, so yeah, this is, thank you, this is just the usual Durham differential. Yeah. Yes, so this is not well, module homomorphism, so this is not just the sheaf vector space. Yeah, so F is, no, F is just, F is.
F there,
on the right, F. Yeah, so this is an example of the section. Not every section is written in this way. It's not written in this way, but. So this is an example of the section. Yes, but just one example. Yes, of course, well, if I is given by the differential of the function F, and if you just differentiate this function, then, of course, by the definition, after after taking differential of this f, then its image is contained in this ideal. So, well, this function f is regarded as a section of this sheaf. When you use smooth itself, yeah, for example, Rev, yeah. When you use smooth itself, Rev. Sorry, I'm a bit confusing. Right, when U is smooth, right, for example, you can take just, for example, like the function F to be just a constant function, and right, it is nothing but the kernel of this map. So this is just the constant sheaf. Yes, rank one. So, anyway, the theorem by Joyce and his collaborator is well, there is a certain canonical global section such that, so this is a canonical global section. Such that where there is a certain data like this, which I denote by star, and such that S restrict to each UI given in this way. So the good point of here is that well, we can take this data so that it is compatible in some way. And in fact, if we have this condition, then on the overlap, then each function fi at worst differ by some adding like a quadratic form. And using that difference, given by the quadratic form, we can give a canonical isomorphism between each canonical bundle if I tensor 2 restrict to uij and kvj tensor 2 restrict to UIJ. So this gives canonical isomorphism. And this means that each these line bundles group together to get certain line bundle on M. So this group to give line bundle, which I did not buy M virtual. So this is line bundle on M. And indeed, so this line bundle can be described using the determinant line bundle, and the determinant line bundle that is, I take R from EE and PM star, so it's the universal sheaf. So this means that if we have this means that by using that global decritical structure, so that section is called decritical structure. So using that decritical structure, this means we have a canonical isomorphism of this virtual canonical bundle and the canonical bundle of each critical chart tensor by 2. But using this data, we can describe how what is the difference of the sheaf vanishing cycles on overlap. So roughly speaking, indeed the sheaf vanishing cycles on the overlap are not the same, but they are, the difference is given by certain rank one local system that is defined by that is defined by taking the mu2 torsor, which parameterizes local square root of this canonical isomorphism. So in order to cancel out that difference, we need a square root of this virtual canonical bundle that is called orientation data. So if we choose, this square root that is M. So yes, indeed, it is not, it may not be necessary. A priori, it may not be obvious that whether a square root exists or not, but it is proven in the paper of Nekrasov and Konkov. That's an important point. So, and what they prove is that indeed the first chunk class of this virtual canonical bundle is even. So at least there is one. So at least there is one square root, but it's not canonical. So anyway, so if you choose one of the square root, then it is possible to glue the local perverse sheaves to give a global perverse sheaf. So I will omit some detail, but the statement is that there is rank one local system on each UI such that if I tensor this sheaf vanishing cycle with FI, then this glue to give global perverse sheaf. So let's write this sheaf of vanishing cycles. But yes, depends on the choice of orientation. Yeah, exactly. So, yes. Indeed, so this depends on the choice of orientation data. So this choice is called orientation data. But if you are given one orientation data, then there is a global purpose shift. And we want to use this kind of purpose shift to give a Kobakuma buffer invariant for singular module space M. But another problem is that this Seehoff vanishing cycles may not satisfy the Bernstein-Dwin decomposition theorem. This means, it is true that this is coming from the mixed Hodge module, that is, there is a natural functor from mixed Hodge module M, and it is coming from here. And but this may not be pure. And indeed, well, there's, yeah. This may not be pure. Because of this issue, well, instead of using this Seehoff vanishing cycles in the paper of Jun Lee and Yong-Fun Kim, they introduced their Kobakuma buffer invariant using the associated group of the weight filtration. So that is Kim Lee. Use associated group of weight filtration of this Seehoff vanishing cycles. If you use the associated group, then each direct summand is a pure Hodge module, and we can apply the decomposition theorem, and we have the invariant, which I denote by B. And the good thing about this invariant is that at least genus z equals zero, it coincides with the Kobakuma buffer invariant coming from stable pairs, that is, on the other hand, let's consider the higher genus case. So there are some issues on yes. Yeah, that's what I want to say. Yeah, indeed, so they didn't mention about the dependence of orientation data, and we find that in the higher genus case, it depends on the choice of orientation data. Yes. First issue is that when G is positive, one depends on orientation data. Yes, the example it is easy to see the example. Yeah, indeed, in this construction, well, we may also assume that the moduli space is just non-singular. And for example, well, if you consider a super-rigid elliptic curve inside the Calabi C-fold, then the moduli space M is just elliptic curve. And in this case, there are some square root of the trivial line bundle. And if you choose some non-trivial square line bundle, then we get some contradiction about this equality in the higher genus. And another issue is that, well, in this construction, we are doing several artificial things. That is, we choose some orientation data, take associated group of the weight filtration, and so on. And the definition is complicated, and it's quite, well, from this definition, it's not easy to compute the invariant from the definition And indeed, in their paper, they didn't mention, so yes, so this was a paper by Sun-Kin. So they didn't give any example about the comparison with this, the invariant with either Gromov-Witt invariant or stable pair invariant when the modular space M is indeed singular. So there is no one example where NG beta P equals to beta K KM. NG is positive and M is indeed singular. So now I'm going to talk about a proposal. Yes. Our proposal is that in order to understand Kopakuma buffer invariance, I think we need further stronger geometric statement, strong property of the geometry of the modular space of one-dimensional stable sheaves. So this is our proposal. So this is a joint work with Damesh Malvik. This is still in progress. Yes, first we have to think about the first issue. So whether there is a canonical orientation data or not. So indeed, well, from the context of motivic Donaldson-Thomas invariant, in order to apply for the application of Wolf coaching, we need to choose orientation data that is compatible with whole algebras. But the existence of such orientation data compatible with whole algebra is not yet is not known. And even if there is such compatibility statement, we don't know whether there is a canonical one or not. But instead, let's consider this map that is here with the chair map. So this is somehow higher dimensional analog of the like Hitchin vibration. So I mean if you have modular space for Higgs bundles, you have the Hitchin vibration and the generic fiber is certain Abelian variety and that is indeed some Abelian vibration or in particular this that is Calabi-Yau vibration. And what we think is that this map is interpreted as something like a Calabi-Yau vibration in some partial sense. So in particular, we believe that well, if you consider the partial canonical bundle, then this is trivial among the fibers of this map. And this is true when on the smooth fiber. We don't know whether this is true on single fibers or not, but it can, I think it, yeah, we may expect that it's true. But we expect more stronger conjecture. Well, I'm not sure whether this is true in general or not, but in the case which we computed, this is satisfied, so I write it as a conjecture, but for any point in char beta x, there is a open subset and you write the pullback of this beta chair map. So this is inverse U. Then there is a critical chart on this pullback and the linear function here such that this is given by the critical locus of this function. Or more strongly, this gives the so-called D-critical chart that is if it's the global section of SM restricted to MU. So we have this property in particular implies that the strong assumption is that where this canonical bundle of J is trivial, that is J equals to H of J. Yes, exactly. Sorry. Yeah, I don't know what this means, but yes. Virtual Clavier vibration in some weak, strong sense. I think we may talk about virtual Clavier vibration that is assuming that this virtual canonical bundle is coming from the pullback or line bundle or so on. And indeed, in this case, if this condition is satisfied, the virtual canonical bundle restricted to MU is indeed trivial. And if this condition is satisfied, of course, we may choose the orientation data on here, just the square root, just a trivial square root, that is. So anyway, let's assume that this condition is true. Then under this conjecture, we can define the local Kobachmann buffer invariant by the condition that IF restricted to gamma. Also, another good condition of this property is that if you consider the C for vanishing cycles here, this is not coming from Pierre Hodge module, but still by using the compatibility with the vanishing cycle shifts and for a push forward, we can see that this shift for vanishing cycle satisfies the decomposition theorem. And of course, this is given by like this. And of course, and the point is that if we take this chart, as long as it gives the D-critical structure, this local Kobachmann buffer invariant gives a well-defined constructive function that is indeed independent of the choice of orientation data. So this is well-defined. Yes, right. But if you take,
on the square root. So here,
Yes, whenever j is collabial, and whenever this function gives the critical chart, this gives a well-defined constructive function. So it is independent of the choice of orientation data. And the global Kopackmann buffer invariant is just given by integration of the integration of this function. So this gives, as long as this conjecture is true, then this gives a well-defined Kopackmann buffer invariant. But of course, well, this conjecture, I'm not sure whether, this seems to be not so easy, but of course, another conjecture is that, well, of course, NG beta P equals to NG beta, of course, under conjecture A. Yeah, so here is the main theorem. So this is with Hashimov weak that let X be the total space of canonical bundle on smooth projective surface. And let's take beta will be irreducible curve class. That is, beta is not written as effective curve class, written as sum of effective curve class. Sorry, and with first batch number equals zero. Well, so this is still work in progress, and I think it should be not difficult to improve the result. But anyway, so the conclusion is that in this case, the both conjectures are true. And it's first batch number zero. Only this. We can avoid that this is general type. But the strong assumption is that with beta is irreducible. And I think we can improve that beta is a primitive curve class, but maybe with some effort, I think. I think we have already almost proven that, but anyway, so the point is that in this case, it involves like more, many examples that M is singular. So here, yes, I'm giving one example. So yes, let S to be NK surface. And which admits elliptic vibration. Such that where let's take one of the double fiber so that H, so that H inverse P is twice of C and assume that C is a nodal rational curve. So there are some examples of NK surface like this. So in this case, let's take beta to be this curve class. Then because this is double fiber, the curve C is rigid inside S. So the chair variety inside this surface is just 1 point because this curve C is rigid. But if you consider the deformation of this curve inside three-fold X, then it is not one point. I mean, so indeed, if you restrict, if you take its global section of omega s to C tilde, C tilde is, so this is normalization. This is one-dimensional. This means that, well, on surface, I have this nodal rational curve, and inside, on the seaport, so there are something like this happens. So this is S, and this is X. So indeed, in this case, the child by D is by A1. And yes, and in this case, the moduli space of one-dimensional stable sheaves is indeed, so theoretically, this is either a rank one torsion free sheaves on this rational curve or line bundle on P1. So this is composed into C or A1. So yeah, C equals to 0, and A1 to A1 is just identity map. So if we devote over the picture, this looks like like this. So this is a moduli space, and here, so there is a singularity. So this singularity is given by critical locus of some function like this, and the Hilbert child map is given by like this. So we can write it as the Calabi-Yau critical locus. That is, let's take, this is a bursal deformation of C. So this is, of course, Calabi-Yau, and if we take C product A1 to the product A1 to A1, and this function is xy to xy, and we compose it with this one. Then this moduli space of stable sheaves is just given by df equals 0. And in this case, obviously, this is Calabi-Yau, and this gives, yeah, so this gives an example of moduli space of stable sheaves with singularities. And indeed, in this case, the theorem can be proven like using the result of Movik, Shende, and their collaborators showing some similar results for the bursal deformations of irreducible planar curves. And just applying the sheaf of vanishing cycles and proving the conjecture A, we get this result. So thank you very much.